Hey people, this is Craig McRetro again from DOSGamers.com, and well, I thought that it was time to record another video for the channel, because it's way too long ago when I've last uploaded a video. So in this video I'm going to explain how to play DOS games on Windows 10. Yes, and of course we start off at our website DOSGamers.com. And this is the general DOS games page, on which there's general information about DOS games, how to play DOS games, something about the Windows command prompt, source ports and that stuff. It's quite interesting to read. Over here on the left side, all the games, here are all the games that can be played with a source port. And what's a source port? Well, that's also on this page over here. But in this video I'm going to show you how to play DOS games again with the DOSBox DOS emulator. So we're going to the DOSBox page by clicking either this link or the DOSBox link in the web in the menu. And of course, if you want to start playing DOS games with DOSBox, you need to install DOSBox by going to the website www.dosbox.com. Click on this link over here, and we'll take in this case we'll take the Win32 installer. It's the first link on Windows. It starts to download immediately, and save this file anywhere on the disk, doesn't matter where. In this case I'll take the games ISO and install folder. And well, when it has downloaded, started up by clicking this this thing. I'm in the Chrome browser right now. Allow Windows to make changes to my device, of course, and then the installer of DOSBox starts up. Click on next, next again, and well, in this case, I'll just use the default installation folder of DOSBox. And click on install, and that's it. Close it. And yeah, well, to use DOSBox, of course and obviously we need a DOS game. So we go back to the DOSGamers.com website, and on that website I have a link to the DOSGames.com website without an R. And over there you find well, lots and lots of free DOS games, and that are either demos or shareware or freeware games. So that's a good thing. No piracy going on there. Okay, let's see. What game am I going to play? Well, I'm going to search this website and click on the game index link. Let's see. Lots of games over here. Dum de dum de dum. Wow, that's our a lot of games over here. Let's see. Well, everybody of course knows Prince of Persia. Yeah, or Lemmings perhaps. Yeah, let's take Lemmings over here. Okay, searching. It's over here. Download it. Click here to download. Okay. Save the file, also anywhere, doesn't matter where. Save it and open the zip file once it has been downloaded. Right now we're into the zip file, so we need to copy those files from the zip file to an empty folder of choice. Select the files by clicking the first one, press the shift button and click the last one. Right mouse button on one of the files and click copy. And in my example I'm going to DOS, the D drive, games and the DOS games, and I'm going to save these files in LEM1, the LEM1 folder. It's a crappy name, but Lemmings folder already exists, and the LEM folder also. Well, anyway, I'm going to save it in the LEM1 folder. right click in this area over here and choose paste. Okay, here we go. There are the files, the game files to play the game. Well, obviously on Windows 10 these files can't be played, because if I double click this one, for example, we need either a .exe or a .bat file or a .com, but .exe is most likely the game file. If I do that, double click it, well, my PC says this app can't run on your PC, so that's yeah, crap. But we're going to play the game with, of course, DustBox, and we just installed DustBox. To run it, just click the search glass and type DustBox and press enter, and it starts up. In my case, I have some configuration settings which allow me to play the games in a somewhat larger screen, but how to do that, that's something for another video. Right now I'll just show you the simplest way to play the DOS game, to play Lemmings, which I have just downloaded from the website dosgames.com. The first thing you need to do is mount a drive in DOSBox which points to a folder on your actual hard drive. So we start off with a Z drive over here, and right now we don't have a C drive. To check that, press the C and the colon and press enter, and you see over here that it does not exist. So what we're going to do is make it exist, and you can do that by typing mount C. That's the first C is the drive that's going to be created in DustBox, and after that I'm going to type the folder which contains my DOS games, and that's on the D drive, D colon backslash games backslash DOS, enter. Right now drive C is mounted as local directory D games DOS, and to go to the C drive right now I just do the same, press the C and the colon, press enter, and now right now I'm in the C drive in DOSBox. Well, actually it's better to use another letter, because you also have a C drive on your actual hard drive, of course, and well, it may be that you mix up the drives and delete some files, perhaps, I don't know. Well, in that case it's better to have another folder, just like a G folder, or not anyway, a folder that doesn't, a drive that doesn't exist on your actual drive, like mount P that points to T games DOS, and that's a way you cannot mix up the drives. Okay, so let's say this is my drive in DOSBox. It's the P drive right now, and actually I'm into the games DOS folder on my D drive. So let's see what's in that folder, and I'm going to do that by typing dir from directory, and there's a lots of stuff in there. I'm only interested in the lem1 folder right now, so I'm going to type cd, and that's change directory space lemm1, enter, and to see what's in this folder I again type dir, and right now I'm want to start the VGA version of Lemmings, and well, no, I'm going to start the CGA. Yeah, that's retro, nice retro, and I'll do that by typing CGA and then press the tab button, and it takes the first file that starts with CGA, and that's CGA lemmy.exe file. And to start a file in DOSBox, we need either a .exe file or .com file or a .bat file, but .exe files are most likely the files you need to start up. In this case, I'm going to start up the CGA version of Lemmings and the demo version, of course. Enter. Okay, here we go. Please choose the appropriate machine. That will be a PC for my. Okay, so wow, let's look at this. The CGA version of Lemmings. Wow. Okay, I'm going to press F1 button and start a new game. Just dig. Number of Lemmings 10. 10% needs to be saved. Okay, well, let's go. And there are those little creepers. Dig, just dig. All of you. Wow, it's a great game. It's a classic. And I think one of the lemmings is going to die. No. Here we go. Well, actually, that's the simplest way to start a DOS game in DOSBox. Just mount the drive and start up your game. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, just ask them in the comments beneath. And I'll see you in the next video. Alright. Keep it retro, everybody. Bye bye.